an excellent music performance to share with all of you. Third grade class, you should do this evening, playing instruments and singing. Our first song is I'd Like to Teach the World to Sing, which was originally used for a Coke commercial. It became so popular, it was made into a whole song. Our soloist star, Evan Rice, Kingston Green, and Margot Newman, and Mahi Runner.
Thank you.
the traditional American folk song. This song is set up in Christmas rain form. The song tells of the beauty of our countryside and will feature Miss Blair's class again on the instrument.
Cover the gourd. Here's Miss O'Connor's class playing Take Time in Life.
Famous folk songs. Its lyrics were written by American folk singer Woody Guthrie. Tonight we will sing two verses of this American folk song.
Cooperation and
conservation. Deep in the forest one morning, Pigeon Post is going about her usual business when she notices a huge X on the trunk of an old tree. All the tree's residents have a different theory about whom to blame until Captain Crow solves the mystery. But can they stop their quarreling before it's too late? Let's listen and find out.
Two woodsmen were walking through the woods. They came upon an old tree.
Look here, what do you think?
Looks good to me. Go ahead and put an X on it.
The woodsmen took two big pieces of red tape and marked the tree with a big X. The woodsmen continued on to work. However, Pigeon Post was just beginning her day delivering the mail to the old tree. She walked up to Mrs. Rabbit's store and knocked.
To walk to Professor Owl's door.
I'm dreadful. I've got an appalling headache because of the frightful screeching of those parakeets. Not to mention Mr. Woodpecker's remodeling upstairs.
So you haven't been outside then? You haven't seen the big X on your tree?
Outside, outside. The sun is far too bright for my eyes. Good day to you, madam.
Pigeon now only had two more stops. She walked toward Maggie Magpie's door, but before she even had the chance to ring the bell, Maggie answered the door.
Hello there, darling. Gossip today again. Are all those parakeets still driving everyone crazy? Today's mail looks official. Have you been thieving again, Maggie?
It's not thieving, darling. It's what magpies do. You see shiny, fluffy things and we pick them up. I suppose all those busy bodies downstairs think I'm a thief.
I don't know, but I do know that you have a big X on your tree.
Really, darling? Really, darling?
Finally, Pigeon was headed towards her last stop. However, the last stop was the very top of the tree, so Pigeon began the long way up the tree.
But she was breathless.
I have a postcard for you. A big X on your tree. What does it mean?
Thank you, matey.
Captain Crow was busy reading her postcard, but seconds later, she realized what Pigeon had said.
Wait, did she say X? I know what X means, matey.
Pigeon had already gone, so Captain Crow looked through her telescope, and her worst fears were confirmed.
Everyone gathered at the bottom of the tree, except Mr. Woodpecker. They all stared up at the X.
What could it mean? Who could have done it?
And why?
Captain Crow was frantically ringing her bell and pointing, but no one had understood her. She was too far away.
So for the first time ever, Captain Crow went down to the bottom of the tree.
What shall we do?
Suddenly there was a sound. Chop, chop, chop.
What thudded around them?
They were terrified. They all screamed.
Help! 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 Help!
Don't cut it down!
Then the chopping noise stopped. A small cough and they all looked up. And the X was gone. Instead, there was a hole, and in it was Mr. Woodpecker.
Oh, hello, everyone. I need a bit more space, so I'm building it. Could you lend me a hand?
Since Mr. Woodpecker had given everyone such a fright, everyone started to shout at him.
Oh, my
God. What is it? What
are you thinking?
Are you crazy?
Sorry, everyone. I didn't know about the X.
Listen. I thought I gave it right to save your tree.
Pigeon began to go around and said, they worked together. It took the whole day, but by the evening, all traces of the X were gone. In fact, it looked as if it had always been there.
After all the work was done, they all went quietly to wait and see if their plan had worked. The next morning, everyone woke to hear voices outside. Human voices.
Well, look at that. I could have sworn he painted X on this tree. It doesn't really
too.
Gosh, looks rather special. Better not touch it. I don't want to cut down a tree in such a beautiful birdhouse.
After the woodsman walked away, Captain Crow rang her bell for everyone to come out.
No. It was all of us working together to save our tree. Let's cheer for all of them.
Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray!
And that night, they had a wonderful party.
Thank you. Oh.